Tonight, Sandy Gilmore substitutes for Terry Wood.
Accused killer Theodore Bundy was captured early this morning, 2 miles from Aspen, Colorado. He was on the main road driving a car he admitted taking just a short time earlier. Barbara Grossman was in Aspen this morning and has this report.
At 2 this morning, after being loose for 6 days, Bundy was captured by Pitkin County officers Maureen Higgins and Gene Flatt. But they weren't looking for Bundy. They were on a routine investigation.
I noted a vehicle driving erratically about an eighth of a mile east of Aspen on Highway 82. We observed this vehicle for a matter of seconds, and I turned around and pursued it, contacted it, and found Mr. Bundy driving it.
Did you recognize him right away?
It took about 2 glances. He was pretty altered. His appearance had been altered by glasses and a minor growth of beard.
Actually, he was pretty dopey. I think he was pretty tired. He was cooperative in that he pretended to search for his license when we asked for it, and he wasn't aggressive toward us in any way.
Did he say where he was heading?
He did not.
He just stated he was going to leave the valley if possible.
Bundy was brought into court this morning.
Hi, Ted.
How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Here.
He had lost about 15 pounds. His body was scratched. He injured his knee while mountain climbing. He was exhausted, disoriented. Judge George Lohr advised him of additional charges: escape, second-degree burglary, misdemeanor theft, and a felony theft. If convicted of these charges alone, Bundy could spend 90 years in prison. Bundy gazed around the room as the judge spoke to him. Officers say Bundy was very talkative this morning when apprehended. He told all about his escape. Police say after he fled the courtroom last Tuesday, Bundy headed for the hills southwest of Aspen. Bundy came here Wednesday after spending a miserable night in the rain. He told officers he broke into this cabin where he ate and slept Wednesday night. This is also where the rifle was taken. All the time, Bundy was only 5 to 8 miles away from Aspen. Last Saturday morning, police found the cabin with Bundy's fingerprints inside. Then that night, Bundy returned to the home and realized officers had been there. He slept outside under a tree with temperatures reaching below zero. Yesterday, Bundy told police he hid in the area while a search helicopter landed just 100 yards away. Last night, Bundy walked 5 miles into Aspen and stole this car. It was unlocked. The keys were inside. He was on his way out of town, but for some reason made a U-turn. That's when he was apprehended. Today, security was bolstered. Bundy must have shackles on his ankles while in the courtroom. He will be guarded around the clock. Bundy made his escape by jumping out of this two-story window. Today, his footprints remain, and the courtroom windows still have no locks. Barbara Grossman, Newswatch 2, Aspen, Colorado.
The police in Aspen, Colorado are smiling again tonight. 6 days ago, they left accused killer Theodore Bundy alone in the Pitkin County courtroom. He jumped from a two-story window to his freedom. Early this morning, he was apprehended again. Barbara Grossman has a report from Aspen.
Two officers, Maureen Higgins and Deputy Floyd Flatt, were pulling a routine car stop. He was driving erratically, and they thought he might be driving under the influence.
Listen, there will be a court
hearing. When they got him pulled over, it was Ted Bundy himself.
This morning, they were willing to talk about Bundy. He was once again behind bars. At 2 a.m., officers Maureen Higgins and Gene Flatt were out on a routine investigation.
I noted a vehicle driving erratically about an eighth of a mile east of Aspen on Highway 82. We observed this vehicle for a matter of seconds, and I turned around and pursued it, contacted it, and found Mr. Bundy driving it.
Did you recognize him right away?
It took about 2 glances. He was pretty altered. His appearance had been altered by glasses and a minor growth of beard.
Did he say where he was heading?
He did not.
He just stated he was going to leave the valley if possible.
The 6 days in the hills of Aspen showed. This is what Bundy looked like last Tuesday before his escape. Today, he was 15 pounds thinner. There were scratches all over his body. He limped from a bruised knee, and he seemed very confused. Officers were confident he could not survive in the wilderness for long. They were right. Bundy told them he was glad it was over.
Bundy was back in court this morning.
Hi, Ted.
How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Here.
Judge George Lohr advised him of additional charges: escape, second-degree burglary, misdemeanor theft, and felony theft. If convicted of these counts alone, Bundy could spend 90 years in prison. Police say he was talkative about his escape. According to Bundy, after he fled the courthouse last Tuesday, he headed for the hills southwest of Aspen. Bundy came here Wednesday after spending a miserable night in the rain. He told officers he broke into this cabin where he ate and slept Wednesday night. This is also where the rifle was taken. He traveled a lot, but during the entire time, Bundy was only 5 to 8 miles away from Aspen. He watched as a police helicopter landed just 100 yards away. He slept outside in sub-zero temperatures. Then last night, Bundy said he walked into Aspen, took this car, which was unlocked and had the keys in the ignition. He was on his way out of town, but for some reason made a U-turn. That's when Bundy was apprehended. On Thursday, Bundy will be back in court on his latest charges. And there are new security measures. His ankles will be shackled at all times while in the courtroom. Barbara Grossman, Newswatch 2, Aspen, Colorado.